are you? My name is Kate Ife. Today I'm going to be reading The Friendliest Ballerina, written by Timothy Knapman. Bella loves her ballet class. She's the best dancer by far. Today they've got a show to prepare and Bella will be the star. But then Miss comes to Bella and says, "This is Peter and Claire. They are new. Bella, will you take care of them and show them what they should do?" Peter is small and Claire is shy. So Bella says, "Welcome. Hello. I'm so glad you've joined us. It's just the right time. You'll both get to be in our show." Bella shows them where to hang up their coats. She tells them what everything is for. She helps them make friends with everyone else. She couldn't do anything more. But not long ago, if you'd asked her for help, Bella would have said, "Sorry, but no. I'm far too busy to help anyone. You see, I'm the star of the show." Back then, she danced in the spotlight, where she shone like a star on her own. But after the show, when the lights had gone out, Bella felt sad and alone. Of course, Bella thought, what a silly I've been. Being happy or sad all depends, not on being the star of the show, but whether you've got any friends. So now look at Bella, how happy she is as she dances with Peter and Claire. Peter is small, but he jumps very high, while Claire spins and twirls everywhere. Then in no time, it seems it's the night of the show. Bella's nervously waiting to start. Then Claire comes along and gives Bella a hug and a thank you that warms Bella's heart. Bella springs out on stage and she dances so well that the mummies and daddies all cheer. Bella's never been better and we know why. It's because her two friends are near. It's good to be the star of the show, but remember how our story ends. It's sad to be lonely, so never forget to smile, help out, and make friends. The Friendliest Ballerina. That's why I love storybooks. They make you meet people or characters just like you. Books are amazing, don't you know? They take you to places you never knew you could go. Take care. Bye.